All right. Hi there. My name is Zoran Tanevski. I'm coming from Macedonia. That's a small, picturesque country at the south of the Balkans. I am a Joomla developer and user since probably the version 1.0.8. But it's somehow, I think that last 8 number just sticked somehow. Probably it was maybe 6 or 15, doesn't matter. And also at that time, we were just crafting websites as well with Mambo. Is everyone knows what Mambo was at the days? Yeah. Currently, I'm a web developer at Joomla team. That's a whole service Joomla web development agency based in Zagreb and Munich. And actually, the last point in my short biography was added by my boss, which is not here, but I decided to leave it here. So maybe we will discover together what he was actually meaning with this. An unaccomplished comic artist. And yeah, what's it all about anyway? And what we are going to talk about this today. We will talk about actually improving our development workflow. We will talk about our specific approach to a development with production environments that we built actually a couple of months ago. We'll that also had to do something with allowing non-developers to also make some clones and deploying of the sites. And actually, it's about a tool in the end that we've built it using Akeeba Unite framework. Anybody knows what's Akeeba Unite? I knew you would know it. And yeah, and the tool we just built it with, I would say, with its power. And actually, it's about sharing our experience we gained with you, because that's the most important thing in Joomla, anyway. So, you know what? It was actually about this. It will be actually about this, specifically about this guy in, at the left, because we love it. And you could, I don't know, inject some poisonous code inside him, and you just don't worry, just reboot it, and you're good again. And versus this guy on the right, which is favored for with our clients, they just want it like this, snobbish and shining and locked, etc. So we were provided with these two guys at a specific moment of our development, everyday work. And our challenge was actually to make these guys work together in a nice way. So what was the situation? Actually, as developers, we kind of not just start doing things without some situation being developed behind, you know. So unless you're unemployed, probably. So what was our situation? We had a really wide array of Joomla sites for a big client, kind of 20 at that moment. And the request for new sites were just coming and coming every other, let's say every other week or so. At that time, there was no any structure at place that would just help us developers or content administrators or whatever to just make changes to the sites in a more systematic way. Mostly the changes was directly made the old-fashioned way, directly on the live sites. And sometimes you have to do what you have to do anyway. And as the numbers of sites increased, a clear need for a development workflow grew. So we had to do some structure that will help us maintain this very important client of us. What were actually the problems? There were a couple of really big problems for us. I would say showstoppers that kind of needed immediate attention from us. First problem was this client request. They were like trying to meet these ISO requirements on their IT infrastructure. And they were trying to minimize live site edits. What was that meaning was kind of you just stop doing what you are doing at the moment and find some other way, you know. Actually, what happened is more like this. One day this guy showed up and he said, don't touch that FTP button anymore, you know. Yeah, the next one was also a client request. They implemented some really aggressive front-end caching, and there was no means for us in any way to just do anything about it. For example, if you just made some change to some front-end files like CSS or JavaScript, you had to wait like 3 to 4 hours maybe to show up and to see your changes. And we were kind of forced to use that setup. But at that moment, I was kind of sneaky suspicious that this guy actually had to do something with this. I'm sure as a Joomla developers, you already met a few of them. So, you know, these guys like, hey, Joomla sucks, you know, it's not secure. Anyway, it's heavy. So let's make a 3 hour caching for you to just make your life a lot harder than it should be. And the next one was the debugging at that time. There was actually, when you're dealing with some live edits on the production side files, we all know what kind of risk that takes with it. So also there was something that has to be done in this regard. Actually, I would tell you a little anecdote here. There was this Joomla junior developer that just was eager to go sooner home that day. It was Friday, yeah. And actually, he forgot to delete his var dump line in his code. And what we actually found out the next Monday was this on a couple of sites there. So we had these strange phone calls, a couple of them that day. So yeah, the situation was not really bright at that moment. Also we lost time. Creating dev sites as case per case basis was kind of just a waste of time and cumbersome. So, for example, imagine you have like 20 sites and you have like 10 tasks per day per site. And imagine yourself doing development versions of the production sites, etc., etc. That was kind of impossible to go with it. So, also, we developers have kind of some better things to do than building dev websites and clones, like team building, for example. The process. So something had to be done, clearly. So we had some conversation in our team. We had some research done, etc. And we came up with some kind of general structure of what should we do about this and what kind of approach and probably a solution we need at that moment. That solution should have the following things, like and functions. First one was to just create clones for us from the production side to the development server. So actually copying the production side on the dev server. Then actually also the feature to overwrite existing dev site. The second feature should have been deploying. So we should, our tool should have some kind of feature to copy the dev site to the production server and should actually overwrite existing production site. And also there should be these two remaining features like locking the development sites that was kind of need to prevent each other's overwrites, either that was on some PHP code or some front-end code or some content in administration, anything. So actually that lock part was used, which should be used during the development of the development. And the freeze part should have been kind of freezing the production side while we were actually doing the changes to, the video bay. And yeah, freezing the production side while we were making the changes to the development side. And we did that with some kind of HD access wizardry, etc. So it was basically a lock-in access to the administrator of your Joomla site. So actually, in a more graphical way, we had to build something like this. These are the features. Number one is production to development. Number two is development to production. And number three and four are locking the dev site and freezing the production site. And we kind of had all of this structure in our heads, and we were just trying to achieve it. So we also had some clear picture of the workflow that the future developers would just take in this situation, and that would be like the first step they should take should be cloning the site. Then they should just freeze and lock production and development. Then they should do their job actually. Then unfreeze and unlock production and development and deploy the changes to the production site. So all that was good, and so, but what would be the solution? We did our research phase. We didn't have any versioning control system employed at that time, and all of us were kind of acquainted with some Git versioning, etc. So we had to find some solution that would be like Joomla based, actually. And we were kind of all used to Akeeba backup. Everyone know what Akeeba backup is. It's such an important piece of software anyway. And I did some research and find out that actually Akeeba guys also created this framework called Akeeba Unite, which is awesome. Which is actually a command line application, and it's doing like unattended side backups and restorations. That means no any manual involvement in the backup and the restoration processes. It's basically this just skipping this kickstart step, if you remember. So everything is done behind. You have no involvement in it whatsoever. The only requirement is a simple XML file where you just feed the Unite framework with the necessary data. And thanks to Nick for this great tool in for the Akeeba backup team. I had to tell that because its power, it was really kind of tremendous. And the impact that had on our development workflow and everyday work was tremendous. So I was such a blown away with its power, to be honest. So I decided to just show you a simple restoration. Let me just see. 1 second. Oops. All right, sorry about this interruption, guys. Oh yeah, here it is. What I actually did here is like created a local site that we will use it as a production site. To not use this Wi-Fi here because I don't trust it, you know. And we also have this development site, for example. And let's see the structure. Just a second. Yeah, that kind of resembles our development environment. This is kind of the development root folder, and this is the site, actually the local development site, which is empty at the moment. This, oops. What the fuck? Okay, this is actually this guy, which is empty. And we also have the Unite folder here, which contains only the Unite PHP archive file, the executive at this moment, actually, and the restore XML file. That's the only thing you need. You just fire up your terminal right now and just run it. Unite. And we'll put this flag verbose. You'll find more of these kind of flags, etc., on the Akeeba backup documentation. And we just run it. Hopefully, it will run nice. Yeah, it's ticking, which is good. Meanwhile, we could just have a look at the XML file. Basically, it's kind of created with these three important sections at our situation. First one was the remote part. It's where you actually tell Unite where to find your remote site to download it and to restore it locally. First one was it is the host, actual domain name of the site. This is the important thing, the secret tag. This is actually a secret key that you assign in Akeeba backup backend settings. So actually, with this, you are allowing some front-end backups to be done on your site. And for Joomla, on the component tags, you just put com Akeeba. And you choose your profile, your Akeeba backup profile, and you choose your download mode. How do you want to download this remote site backup on your development server? A recommended way is curl, and we actually also used curl on our case. For example, this delete tag is should you delete the already created backup on your production server or just not. The site info is actually just telling Unite where to find your development site. Nothing so fancy here. And also this database info is the place where you actually tell Unite where to find your, tell Unite all your database credentials, etc. It's pretty usual stuff for us Joomla developers, like dbhost, dbuser, dbpass, dbname, prefix, etc., etc. So actually, that's all we have to do. Let's see if Unite finished. Yeah, it actually finished. And see if we have our development site. We actually do. Wasn't that awesome, guys? No? All right. Sorry? No, no, it's my specific setup. No worries. All right. So right, so what actually happened right now? Unite just made some remote backup of your site, downloaded it to the development location, at the same time restored it, just like that. I mean, in a nice way. This all was good in a way, and everything, we were all amazed, and so, but I knew a couple of people that when you mention to them like terminal of command prompt or shell or whatever, they just get blue and green in their faces and just jump out of your room. So yeah, we had to do something with this and extend it beyond the just terminal execution of this script. Actually, probably that was not intended at all, so by the developers of the Akeeba Unite. But actually, we had some job to be done, so we had to use what we had at the moment. So what we did actually, what we were going to do actually, we had to make some simple, easy to use tool with some simple and easy to use UI. So actually every non-technical user, like content administrator, designer, whatever, could just use it and create clone sites, etc. And probably, if you allow them, maybe restore the development sites to the production. It should also be run in the browser, like every other thing today is run in the browser. I think soon we will just wash our underwear under browser anyway. We called the script as usual with some PHP exec system call and with the same input like I just showed you before when I was using the terminal. And our only requirement was this kind of one-click functions, which we all love, I guess. And yeah, and we even gave it a name. The discussion is ongoing, who is the godfather? But I'm sneaky suspicious, I know who it is. So I would like to just show you right now how this tool looked in the end. Oops, fucking Microsoft. This is actually how it looked like. I must note here, this is not the real production tool that we are using. It's kind of a HTML replica done for this occasion only. So what we have here is like, these are these one-click buttons here on the right. So you have a new clone button. You could also write some comment here, I don't know, whatever. So we had some logs, whoever did some clone, whoever did some back to production action, etc., etc. Then we have this dev to prod, which just gets your development side to the production. We also have these two nice little buttons with some nice icons there that are just freezing development, locking development side or freezing the production side while you're doing actually your job. Also, we have some logs here who created what, when, and why he created it. And this is the actual clone URL. This is actually on the left, you have the live site URL. And this is actually the tool that really made our lives pretty much easier and allows to just keep up with the never-ending request for new Joomla sites from our important client, in a way. All right. At this moment, I think that you would have probably some questions like how is this all actually created in the backend, how it's all integrated in Joomla. It's actually integrated in Joomla. Our tool is there, and I don't think that the time will allow us to talk about it anyway. So, actually, oops. I will be more than glad to just respond to every request you would have on my email address, zt@joomla.team. Or you could actually visit our site, joomla.team, where we actually put our mumbo jumbo Joomla things quite regularly there. And also, if you want to know more about Unite, you should just follow this URL, akeebabackup.com /unite. It's awesome. Documentation is also great. Lots of examples there. And it should be quite easy for you to just go there and start just like that. And thank you for attending my presentation. Shit. Yeah. Fucking. Oops. Yeah. Acceptance error. Can you explain that, please?
Yes, I
whoever.
Can.
Yeah.
Usually you have your development.
Yeah. No. We are not usual.
Okay.
We are in the middle of the battlefield between Joomla and the clients. You know, you had to do had to what you have to do in your five days probably. You know. Sorry?
Where does the client test the changes?
On the development side.
On development.
Yeah. That's actually one of the points of building, anyway. Thanks for asking, yeah. This is getting... Probably, that would help. All right. Would you do anything differently with building your tool if you were to start again from scratch? Probably. I think so. One of the things is actually a feature that is on our radar is like when you're doing development to production sites, imagine your production site is quite dynamic, like changing every 5 to 10 minutes or you know, like you have many user interactions, like creating users, etc., etc. So, and while it's locked in the backend, and when your developer just moves the development side to the production, it just there is a possibility to delete everything. We were lucky in that regard because a bunch of our sites were just kind of static sites, and they were not changing that much, except a few forms here and there. But yeah, there is a solution actually for that also. You should carefully build your Akeeba backup profile in the backend. Just skip some database tables that are changing all the time, and you should be good to go. Are you using any version control system? Yes, actually I do. I use Git most of the time. But actually, maybe we were like two of us in a team, in our team, that were kind of versed in version control system. And there wasn't really chance for us to go for a Git education for our, for the rest of our teams, like for a month. This had to be done like in 10 days. So we are proud of what we did at that time. Is that all? Sorry? All right. Is there any question left? Can I get back to my presentation? Thank you. Thank you again, and thanks again for Akeeba guys that provide us with such a great solution. And also, have a peaceful remaining of the conference in Köln. I hope to see you around at the bars. And you know, Joomla and beer goes well together, so we could have a chat. Thank you. Yeah. Cheers.